I'm very excited by this package that's arrived today. It's an EPEver tracer. It's the tracer 2210A 20 amp MPPT charge controller. Of course, this is really made by EPSolar. For some reason, they've decided to name this under the brand EPEver or EPEver. I don't know. Anyway, it's MPPT. It claims efficiency no less than 99.5%. Ultra-fast tracking speed. Multifunction LCD display. Three-stage PWM output. And interestingly, an RS-485 port with industrial standard Modbus open architecture. Fully programmable. Function by PC software or remote meter. That's what intrigues me most about this charge controller. So there's a certificate here with no information on, a user manual, which we might have a look at later, and the actual solar charge controller itself. Nothing else, so we'll get rid of the box. Now, this particular solar charge controller seems to be showing up a lot on eBay at the moment, and it's really rather cheap for an MPPT charge controller. Now, the Tracer series of MPPT charge controllers is well known for being true MPPT, but they've obviously gone for this budget model. I don't know whether that's why they've changed the name to EPEver, but it claims to have a European certificate and that sort of thing. So, first impressions are really good. It weighs quite a bit. There's a big chunky heatsink on the back. Remember I said this is the 20 amp model. In fact, the different ratings, the 10, the 20, the 30 and the 40, are all slightly different physical sizes. So, first things first, I know I want to look inside. So, let's take these four screws off. So just four fairly long machine screws on the back. And which way does it open? This way. Crumbs. Look at that. So I've moved it on its side here so we can see it a little bit clearer on screen. That is a huge inductor. And the enamelled copper wire going into it must be 2.5 mil thick. That's a really big inductor. I'm very surprised. And the wire going back from the inductor is silicon 12 AWG wire. So that all looks pretty nice, doesn't it? The capacitors over here are both 100 volts, 470 microfarad, and this is a 35 volt, 2200 microfarad capacitor. There are two 25 amp fuses here. So down here near the output, we've got some decent resistors here that look like they're probably current sensing for the output. There's a little chip here, an LM2901, is that? I'd need to look that up, but I'm guessing a number of the components down in this section down here are for the RS485 output and configuration port. And with the board round again the other way, there's a chip there which presumably runs the LCD panel and the screen there, possibly even the buttons. And under that fat piece of wire, can you make out? No, perhaps not. There is a microcontroller, but of course what we can't see on the top of the board is the main switching MOSFETs, and they're hidden under here. Might just be able to see a pair there and a pair there. Obviously connected straight to the heatsink. And while we're down here, you can see the temperature sensor connector. All these large connectors here for the PV, the battery, the load, and the RJ45 jack, which does the RS485 communication. So I have to say I'm really impressed with the quality. All the components, you seem to be able to see the model numbers on there, so I can look them all up later. The board looks like it's been coated to keep it protected when it's in harsh environments. And it looks really well put together. So far, it's a big thumbs up. Okay, so I've got the EPEver tracer on the bench now with my porta power meter plugged in on the battery side, so it's going to show battery voltage and the current going into the battery. In this example, I'm going to use a DC to DC converter to simulate a solar panel. It's set to 17.5 volts and 1 amp, so it's 17.5 watts. Okay, let's plug the charge controller into the battery. And the screen comes up there, and we can't see it very well. Let me just... That's much better. Right, okay. So, it's showing that the battery is half charged, three-fifths charged here at 12.69 volts and 12.7 volts on the tracer screen. It's indicating that the load is on, but we have no solar coming in at the moment. It says the battery temperature is 25 degrees. That's inaccurate because I haven't got a temperature sensor attached, so therefore it's making assumptions. Let's turn the solar panel on. So as it goes through those various different parameters on the screen, we can see that we are starting to deliver a small amount of current. There we go, it's ramped it up to 1 amp, just over 1 amp, 1.2 amps we saw there for a second. And of course the battery voltage is at 13.3. So it does seem to be doing true MPPT. The solar panel has been dragged down to 15 volts and is delivering 1 amp exactly. So we're seeing 15 watts coming in, and we're seeing 13.5 watts going into the battery. So that's a reasonable efficiency and a reasonable conversion. The battery is steadily rising, and this seems to be doing a good job of charging my gel AGM battery. So these values go on a carousel. The PV voltage is 14 volts, it says there. I'm agreeing it's about 14.6 at the moment. But you can, using select, go through these manually, and when you release, it will hold on that value for a little while longer. Those two menu, let me get back to those. On the load, when you actually use the select button, you can see you get this menu number, which is how many hours the load should stay on after the solar panels have lost the sunlight, and 117 is manual, so I can turn the load on and off manually. And the other extra parameter you get when you go through manually is this one, which says 2N. And that's the second timer here. And in the manual, if we can see that, no count, it says the load, if we set it to 201, the load will be on for 1 hour before sunrise. So it's obviously got some memory in there to remember when sunrise happened yesterday and to adjust accordingly, you would hope. Now at the moment this battery is getting quite high, 13.999 volts there. Now if we go on to the battery section and press and hold the enter button for 5 seconds, we can choose the type of battery that's connected. So let's go gel, because this is the gel battery I've got at the moment. You can also pick sealed, gel, and flooded. So I'm going to leave mine at gel. And it's the same system to change the load on time. We press and hold enter for 5 seconds, and then we can go through the options for the amount of hours after dusk. I'm going to put mine back to manual. Select. So the EPEver Tracer A series seems really good value. It's the only one of the Tracer series where you get a screen and you don't need to buy the external screen. There's only a limited amount of things you can adjust with this screen. You do need the MT50, I think it is, to change your battery voltage and that sort of thing, using the RS485 port here. However, you can also use a USB adapter and a program available from EPSolar, and in another video I'm going to look at that. So hopefully you'll join me then and you've enjoyed this little review. Please give me a thumbs up if you can, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.